Okay, if you've been struggling to get your streams to stop looking like this, where everything's pixelated and blocky and fuzzy and blurry whenever there's a lot of movement on the screen, to this, where everything is crisp and clear and clean and looks great, you're in the right place. Stay tuned. I'm going to show you how to do it. The three pillars of streaming when it comes to visual quality are resolution, frame rate, and bit rate. And those can work together to your advantage or against each other in terms of image and video quality. But let's talk about resolution. Most people want to stream at 1080p. It's natural, right? The biggest size, generally speaking, most people recommend streaming at in today's climate at time of recording. However, most people don't realize, or a lot of streamers don't realize that I've noticed, streaming at 720, but with really good image quality, will look better at 1080p than a 1080p stream that doesn't have enough bandwidth for the bitrate to support it, or it doesn't have a machine that can keep up at 1080p and also play the game. And so the image quality suffers drastically. So looking at that one at 1080p, even though it's the higher resolution, looks bad compared to the 720 that's now been expanded or blown up. So the trick is we need to find out the best way to create that ratio to get the best video quality that's going to look the best in most situations. Another area where we can play with resolution to get the quality we want, we can split the difference. Your stream PC might be able to handle 720 without issue, but it struggles to keep 1080. But if you streamed at 864, which is another true 16:9 resolution, and the reason why you only want to ever pick true 16:9 resolutions is because that will help your encoder the most. If it's not a divisible by 8 to give you a whole number, your encoder then has to interpolate in order to match that 16:9 because of how the math works with encoding. The math is expecting a 16:9 image, but you're streaming at a resolution that's slightly off from that, which means you get a little bit more blurriness, maybe a little bit more artifacting, and just not quite as clean and crisp as it could be. And you're making your encoder work a little bit harder. So 720, 864, or 1080p. If we can run it at 720, we might be able to get away with running it at 860, which gives us a little higher resolution. So it'll look a little bit better at 1080. It'll still look great at 720, and our machine might be able to handle it. The next pillar is our frame rate. So let's talk about frame rate for a little bit. Most people think 60 frames per second is what we need to stream at, because higher frames per second, good, right? 120, 240, higher frames, awesome. However, those numbers only really come into play when you're actually playing the game, because you have the hand-eye feedback loop where your eyes are seeing the image in relationship to what you're asking either your character or the game to do. First person shooters and things like that will benefit from that higher frames, because if you're really good at the game and you're really quick, you will be able to feel the difference if you played on a 60 frames per second machine versus a 240, for instance. Unfortunately, that doesn't translate into streaming or video for the passive viewer. And so everybody thinks 60 frames per second is what you need to have the best image quality. It's actually counterintuitive, because viewing it at 60 frames per second means your encoder now has to work twice as hard. It's doing double the amount of frames to render it and get it out in real time when you're live streaming. So it's actually better to choose 30 frames per second, even though you're playing at 60 or 120, because to the viewer sitting on the couch or in their chair watching your stream, they don't have that hand-eye feedback loop. So 30 frames per second matches what they're used to watching when they watch movies and TV and cinema, which are often filmed at even 24 frames per second. Because when you're watching it, that looks more natural to the eye in terms of motion blend and movement and things like that. When you go higher, that only benefits the player. The biggest bonus to reducing your stream's frames from 60 to 30 means your GPU is now working half as hard and it's encoding half the amount of frames, which means it has more time to make it a good quality frame, a good render, a good image that will make your stream look cleaner and crisper and better, which is what we're after, right? Then the final thing is the bitrate. And this is where your ISP and the consistency and stability of your internet has the biggest impact on image quality. Because the lower your bitrate, i.e. the slower your internet, the smaller your internet, the cheaper your package, whatever, the lower the bitrate you have to stream at, the harder your encoder has to work. But in order to keep up time, because you're live streaming, it has to cut a lot of corners. So it's taking whatever image you have at whatever frames you have, and it's trying to squish those down to that bit rate on the fly while you're live. And that ends up resulting in the ugliest looking stream, because it doesn't matter about resolution and frames at this point. There's just not enough data to render an image that looks good. So bitrate, Twitch allows you to stream, or recommends you stream, up to 6,000 kilobits per second. You technically can stream up to 10,000, but we'll talk about that. There is a general rule of thumb, if you are a partner and your internet can handle it, to stream at 6K. If you're an affiliate, that gets a little bit more tricky. But the best answer and the quickest answer is stream somewhere in the neighborhood of 3,500 to 4,200 bitrate. And the reason why you do that is because if you're an affiliate, you're not guaranteed a transcoding slot during busy times, during prime time, during busy times of the year. And that means your stream, your viewers will not be able to adjust the quality of the stream in order to continue watching if their internet is slow, which means you're automatically potentially shutting the door on new viewers. Going back to the resolution and the frames, as we're building upon our successes here, as an affiliate, what I have found through testing and through working with other streamers and, you know, applying my background and experience and all of this stuff, if your internet is struggling to stream at 4,200, then, but can hold a 3,500 stable, then set your stream to 720p, 30 frames per second at 3,500. If you can't hold a steady stream at 3,500, I really would recommend getting a new ISP, because anything lower than that, the quality continues and everything just plummets. So your internet just isn't really able to handle it if you can't hold at least a 3,500 bitrate stream steady. If you can hold a 4,200 bitrate stream steady, then bumping up to 864p, being another true 16:9 resolution, you get a slightly bigger resolution, you get a little bit more bit rate to accommodate for that, the image quality will not suffer, and you'll have a nice looking, clean, crisp stream. If you are a partner, it is entirely possible to stream above 6K. However, I learned out the hard way. I was experimenting with streaming at 8K because I'd seen a lot of other streamers doing it. When you're at 8K, you're surfing really kind of close to that 10K. So if you ever have any network congestion, if it fluctuates to such a point that it hits this magic number that only Twitch knows, then they will automatically throttle your stream down to 720p, a really blurry, crappy version at 720p, and no transcoding options. We don't know what that threshold is, but I can tell you from my own experience and from talking to other streamers, if you stream at 8K, you will bump into that problem. And I got to the point where I got tired of worrying about it, so I went back to streaming at 6K. So if you're a partner, I recommend 6K, 1080p, 30 frames per second. After much trial and error and trying all kinds of different formulas and trying all kinds of different things, the net result for a partner, if your internet can support it, is 6K bitrate, 1080p, 30 frames per second. So there you go, guys. That is Ninja614's recommended settings for affiliates and partners on OBS and Streamlabs OBS. I'm not exactly sure which video I'm going to be doing next week, but that's the schedule right now. We're going to be trying to do a video per week on YouTube. Also, don't forget to go to my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/ninja614. I'm live Thursday night through Sunday night, the occasional Monday, starting around 8 or 9 p.m. And come hang out, ask questions, chill, have a good time. I'm usually playing Elder Scrolls Online, but I'll play other games as well. Would happy to have you come hang out and chat with us. So have a fantastic rest of your day, morning, evening, time zone, whatever it is. I am out of here. Bye, 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 bye. Champagne Perrier, finished friends on my face. Looking like I'm from the deep. These no Cartier's. Pockets deep, 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 bro.